42,000 lakes, both large and small, gleam amid the endless forest expanses of the Carrillo Finnish Republic. Tumbling down the rocky hillsides, its rivers form many waterfalls. Hardy and industrious people inhabit these rigorous northern parts, the Karels and the Finns. Fishermen and farmers are lovingly decorated with ornamental carving in wood. The fame of Carelian needleworkers has spread far beyond the Republic. Among the favorite themes in their embroidery are the ancient poems or runes, which tell of their national heroes. Unknown bards had composed them down the ages to the music of the kantele, their national instrument. A 100 years ago, here on the shores of Lake Kuito, under an ancient pine, Arhip Perkunen sang his inspired runes. Taken down in writing, they became one of the world's greatest epic poems, Kalevala. In immortal runes, the singers of Kalevala sang of their love for country. Come, good people, listen, ye who have not heard before the music of these songs immortal. This poetic people identified the rigorous nature of the North with the sleeping giant, the keeper of the earth's riches. Centuries, the streams wasted their power in these turbulent waters. Northern nature kept its riches under cover of the forest until Soviet man turned them to the people's good. Rise, O servant of man, who under the earth in deep slumber lies. And the earth yielded its riches. Marble and granite, porphyry and diabase, mica and the ores of the most precious metals. people's dream of a magic mill that would ease man's labor and make it joyous is coming true. The face of the land of Kalevala changes as one travels from the expanses of Lake Ladoga to the cold waters of the White Sea. Hark, O Mother Earth, awaken. Let rich ears of corn grow where I plowed hard, where I planted, on the land on which I labored. People win ever new lands from the forests and marshes. Here, where only mushrooms grew recently and a carrot was considered a rarity, one finds fruit ripening. Maturin science is defeating the stern climate of the region. The land is becoming fertile. Change their courses. Harnessed waters whirl the turbines of power stations. New towns spring up amid the forest. Degesha, the largest cellulose and paper plant in Europe. This is one of the many enterprises that have sprung up on the Stalin White Sea Baltic Canal, one of the first construction jobs of the Soviet five-year plan. Granite rocks, swamps, forests, and lakes pass the blue ribbon of the canal. The voyage from the Baltic to the White Sea was shortened by 2,500 miles. A large port called Belomorsk was built where the canal empties itself into the sea. Ships of many lands call here. Outlying regions of the country with Petrozavodsk, the northernmost of the capitals of the Union Republics. Petrozavodsk is a city of growing industry, of institutes of higher learning, and the center of scientific thought and research of the Karelo-Finnish Republic. From here that groups of explorers of the Earth crossed and we makers of nature their native land start out in various directions, that the forest be the finer, that the seacoast be the richer, that we only know of plenty and that happiness attend us in our beautiful Karelia. Happy are the songs that the people sing in this land reborn.